This segment, I'll be exploring how advertisement uses images to put across various kinds of messages to the audience it is addressing. One of the fundamental way the advertisement talks to anybody is that first of all, it will make you incomplete. As it is, there is some lacuna in you. As it is, there is some gap in you. You are not complete and you are dissatisfied. Your present moment is not all that ideal. So you can do better. You can be somebody else. You can be in some other place. So this is the kind of doubt, anxiety, and even to some extent a shame that is introduced in the tone. Along with that, it also brings a tone of jealousy, because I am like this, somebody else is in a different position. So that comparison comes in. So whenever you buy a product, it is not just the product you are buying. You are buying the aspiration, the hope, and the value system that the product is selling you. This ad by Raymond, in a way, very iconic about that. If you wear this suit, you are a complete man. Otherwise, no. So you have to always look for the bracket or what is the subtext or what is not said directly in the images. So only if you spend that money and buy this suit, you are a complete man. Otherwise, you are incomplete. The advertisements, in a way, invite you to take part in a certain action. And by doing that, they are also saying at the moment, you are boring. So walk the wild side when that statement is made. If you imagine the other side, is that at the moment you are not wild. At the moment you are doing some monotonous routine job. You come this side and then you will be wild. You come this side, then you'll have the thrill. And to go that side, you have to spend money. So that the kind of tone that is taken, so it's an imagined dialogue that the advertisement is posing, and they use the correct kind of imagery, the correct kind of composition, very optimal use of color. So all tricks in the visual language are used in these advertisements. Always you have to look for what is the primary meaning that is being conveyed, and what is the unsaid part, or what is secondary meaning that is coming through there. Sometimes it's very direct, sometimes it's very indirect. So this is no shape for a girl. Very direct way of, you know, shaming somebody to say that you are, you know, overweight. Or it is about you should be looking at your, you know, face with little more respect, treat it well, because you have to go outside and meet people. There is a kind of dialogue that is being imagined there. And then they are trying to make you look at yourself in different ways than what you already know about. So some more, earlier the expectation again was only with how a girl has to look or a woman has to look, but now the trend is extended to how a man has to be seen with, you know, six-pack abs and the kind of grooming and so on. So that expectation that you have to be seen in a certain way brings in lot of anxiety into many people, because you're not doing the ideal thing. You're not, you know, projecting the ideal figure. You're not being the ideal person and so on. So that gap creates a lot of problem. Ladies, it is your duty to be beautiful. So it's a very straightforward, you can't be otherwise. Or they also use, shaming techniques. As I said, they are trying to make you look at yourself in different way or with a certain sense of doubt. Hubby is coming back, I must look fit and pretty. So you can't be tired, and we saw in another segment how by using the image of goddess, the kind of expectations that was put across through in those images, this also similar. With a face this wide, you are not ready for selfie yet. We spoke about the anxiety of, you know, representation. or the fact that my shirt is not white enough, you know, I should be better, I should do better. And you pose a problem and the solution is given next to that. Your shirt is not white, you use that and then that problem will be solved. So living by comparison is something we have adopted or cultivated over a period of time, and it is very difficult to get over that. The advertisements and the present social media in a way reinforce that. You are constantly comparing yourself to somebody else or something else or somewhere else and so on. So sometimes the comparison is within the frame. There are two people who are comparing the whiteness of the dress. Sometimes it is outside the frame, but you are expected to compare and then feel the jealous or feel more virtuous or feel more powerful. So either you're good or bad, but that comparison is there. And the advertisements very strongly promote that comparison. And here it says cars will now suffer from low esteem, not just people, but also cars. So it's an extended version. And then jealous is, you know, it's part of the whole language that you have to feel jealous and act upon that. Advertisements also freeze the moment of happiness in a certain fixed way. You know, you have to be smiling, and just look at this image, which is so well done in terms of as an image, because both of them are very happy. They are going for a joyride. Her hair is, you know, blowing in the wind. He is smiling. There is no worry in the world. You assume that is going to last for a long time. That is the kind of image that the ads project, which may not be the case. So forever happiness or permanent happiness is one proposition that the advertisements make. You buy something spending a lot of money, and then few days you feel very good. Then you look somebody else, he bought that for us, you know, lesser money, you already feel very bad about it. So this kind of, you know, comparison, and then over a period of time you lose the interest and then you want to buy some more. They also bring in history and fantasy into the way the ads are created. They bring references to historical kings and then a queen for you. And this was Padmini Kaur, which was over a long period ago, that was the, you know, most sought after the vehicle. And Padmini is also a queen. So they equate that history and then the present, and then they assume that you are a man who is buying a car, so you need a queen. So all those combinations are built into this kind of statements that are being made here. And she is bigger than the car. So at some point, the attention is transferred from that aspiration to the car. They also bring in this emotional aspects to the products. There are lakhs of people who are buying that product, but somehow you are told that you are unique because you are using that product. Or you will have all the kind of success because you are smoking. And look at the kind of association. We spoke about what comes within a frame and how the narrative changes because of that. The people who are smoking is not a ragtag beggar, but a very successful people. They are all having a nice party and they are smoking. So if you smoke, you will also become successful. That is the kind of logic that is built up. And there is always a invitation. It's being offered. Enjoy this. You know, why you are just being very droll and dull and all that. Take this, enjoy. The other aspect that is brought into these images is a suggestion given by a friend, suggestion given by another famous actor, or maybe an aunt or an old lady or, you know, grandma. So they tell you what to do. So through them, the advertisements tell you what has to be done. It's for your own good, I'm telling you, you do this. Your problems will be solved. Your headache will be over. Mothers who care use Dalda. So if I invert the sentence, if you are not using Dalda, you are not a mother who cares. So suggestions coming through the in a very friendly way. If you want to be like me, use this soap. You know that is not the reason they look like that, but for a moment that is, you know, forgotten, and the power of the star or heroine is transferred onto these products. I have taken images from different times, but the tone doesn't change. And the products are imagined like in between relationship also, between husband and wife. They bring in this product and then try to make or try to sell that. So this is a very interesting thing. Wives, look this ad over carefully, circle the items you want for Christmas, show it to your husband. If he does not go to the store, immediately cry a little. Not a lot, just a little, he will go. So they're teaching you how to entice and how to ask for it. And also, advertisements have brought in this trend of showing your love and affection through products. It is not through a gesture of care or being there for her or him when the time matters, but it is the love is transferred onto an object, maybe a diamond ring or maybe something else, or a watch, an expensive item. So that becomes a token of your love, so it's transferred to that object. If you buy my cigarette, you will feel as though you're in a open air. You'll be standing next to that cigarette shop, and among the vehicle smoke, you'll also be smoking. But the image that is being projected is that you'll be in one faraway place, all by yourself, nobody else around. So basically, an image of yourself in a very different position, or in a different environment, and a different state of mind is being sold through the product. You're not just buying the product, but you're buying the aspiration, you're buying the feeling that it is bringing. It's also the association with success, association with being adventurous and wild and not being, you know, bored and caught up in a, you know, very routine kind of job. So all those lines starts coming in. From time to time, they also overstate and exaggerate the kind of results that come. And if you use my undergarment, the result that comes through is very dramatic, or you will have many, many girlfriends and so on. So these sometimes people may not believe, but it makes it more attractive. This is also an interesting, train her to be an ideal housewife. So we saw in the different charts how a certain image of how a lady has to behave, what kind of occupations she can do, how she has to look and so on. Now that is being transferred to the next generation. And in the process, they are selling the sewing machine. So once you start looking at the ads in a very critical way, you are not just consuming it without thinking, without any analysis. And then if you just see here, it's a continuation of those images being produced in the chart. The son and the father, they are sitting there, she will cook and serve them. It is also about being very smart. If you use my product, you are very smart. That is the kind of line again and again that is being used. So this is the opposite of calling somebody dull. So you're calling him or her very smart. And then because you are smart, use my product. Because you are smart, you will do like how I am doing or I am proposing. So this is a slightly different tactics there. And there is an emphasis always on the individual and what she or he wants to become. And then you should be always thinking bigger, aspiring for more, asking for more and so on. So it says, what are you made of? So you're questioning the very fundamental image of the person or the idea of his own or worth. So you're worth more than what you are right now. So you ask for more and you will get it. Artists, especially the pop artists who started using the language of advertisements, and in the way they adopted, they also started commenting on the consumerist society, the language of ads, and all the other aspects of design. So the Roy Lichtenstein and many other artists, they use the language of comics, they use the language of the Hollywood movie, or the way the action is projected. So just going for a ride and then we'll have a conversation that we can build around the painting. Also at the time when the consumerism was really taking off, the artists started recognizing that trend very early. They said, now we are going into a phase, we are filled with objects in our life, and that became the theme for the works. And those objects were made very colorful, very attractive. Atul Dodia in India uses a similar kind of strategy. He brings in images from cinema, from popular poster, from the kind of education chart that we saw. And then he creates a kind of a collage of the Indian value systems and imagery that we are so fond of looking on a day-to-day basis. This is the Mother India movie, then this is Gabbar, and this is from the chart, you know, ideal boy, ideal girl. And he also brings in images from the other modern art and contemporary artists. So thereby he mixes up the issues. Andy Warhol is a pop artist, and Marilyn Monroe was a very famous heroine at that time. And he had made series of paintings making her as a repetitive image. And many color schemes are used, but she will remain the same. So it's a kind of play on repetition, but also saying that there is no value in repetition, or how many ever times you see, you are seeing the same image. And then the emphasis is on making very small cosmetic changes. I think one has to really look into that very carefully. You change the color a little bit and then you assume it's a very different person. He also made a lot of the Campbell tomato soup paintings. Again, you know, this was the time when the products and consumerist tendencies were really at the peak in America. And instantly they started criticizing that in a very indirect way. Like how I mentioned, even though there are hundreds of people wearing a similar kind of jeans, each one is made to feel by the advertisement as though they are very individual, they're very unique, they're somebody very special and separate and all that. Similar kind of logic is being attempted here. And I mentioned about Manzoni, who made a package of this shit and he sold it and made an exhibit. And then he also made this work where just by putting the thumbnail mark on the egg, it became something very unique. Now it is no more an ordinary egg. You know, it has got a very special status. So all this kind of logic which we see around in the consumerist market, they started adopting it as part of the work and also subverted the whole meaning of that. So one can safely say that both advertising and art, they share the same visual language, but go in slightly different ways. But from time to time, they have had a relationship of give and take. While advertisement has taken inspiration from art, art has used the language of advertisement to comment on the society. If you have enjoyed watching this video, please press like button. To see more such videos, subscribe to our channel. Thank you.